اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. السلام عليكم and very good morning. Okay, today I would like to talk about a new topic. Okay, a new topic in this world. Okay, I'll talk about dinner. So what do you know about dinner? You know anything about dinar?
It's an Arabic currency.
It is Arabic currency? Well, actually dinar, it is a gold coin. Okay? It is a gold coin. Right? It is a gold coin which is, has been used by our ancestors. Right? From the Persian, okay, from the Sasanian people, and also been used by the Muslims during the Caliphate world, and also being used during the gold standard and also the Bretton Woods system, but really not the gold coins, but they are using fiat money backed by gold. Okay, today I will talk about dinar. Okay, firstly I will give you an outline, okay, on the topic that we are going to discuss today. Okay, the first one, what in the heck we want to use dinar, right? Okay, first is, let's say, currency. Currency crisis. Okay, actually dinar has been put forward by the Prime Minister, by the Sheikh Dr. Mahathir Mohamad, okay, during the summit in Doha, okay, Qatar, in the year 2000, stating that we should implement the dinar to avoid the currency crisis. Okay, before I talk about the currency crisis, I'll give you a brief overview of the Malaysian economy. Malaysian economy. Firstly, in the 60s. Then we talk about the 70s. Then in the 80s. And 90s. And this is where the currency crisis occurred, right? In the 1990s. In the 60s, we depend on tin and rubber as our economic, we export tin and rubber. Right? This is our major economic indicator. Then we shifted to palm oil, right? In the 70s. Because we need something new. Because tin and rubber, tin has been facing depleting resources, and also rubber was facing swing in the prices. Okay, so we shifted from these two to palm oil industry, and also to oil and gas exploration. Okay, and then in the 80s, we shifted again to a more modern economy, right? This time we manufacture, we become an industrialization country. So we become a manufacturing country. Okay? Specializing in electronic and electrical parts. Okay? So we become a more industrialization country. And then in 1990, the 10 years of prosperity from 1986, and because 1986 we have crisis, right? Then we have a 10 years of prosperity, we are hit by the currency crisis. Okay, in 1997. At this time, at this moment, many businesses, many individuals have been distressed. Some of the businessmen also suicide, right? Remember, people jumping from top of the building down to the side, right? This is the case. Because of why? Because of the stock market goes down, right? Stock market goes down, went down, and then they cannot pay the debts. The alone keep on trying to get the money. Okay, so in 1997. The currency crisis occurred, and the reason of the occurrence was Speckle.
Mission.
Okay? Speckle mission. Right? So I will not, this is just a big overview on what we want to implement. Speculation. Okay, speculation was done by several billionaire people who are based in Western countries to have the capabilities of the technological advancement with a switch, okay, with just a push of a button, they can move billions of funds from one market to another market. Okay, for example, they move the fund from Japan to the United States in just a push of a button. Right? So speculation attacked the Southeast Asian countries. Okay? They first attacked Thailand. Okay, before that they attacked Russia. Okay, they attacked Russia and then after that they attacked Thailand. Thailand to Indonesia. Then to Malaysia. Right? Attack Thailand, Indonesia, and Malaysia. But we have also South Korea was being attacked. But we're talking about the Southeast Asian countries. Well, when these speculators attack one country, the confidence of the investors to the stock market and also to the investment in the countries will be lacking. So the consequences of the speculative attack will reduce the confidence of the investors. So what they do is that they will take their money out from KLSE. Move the money out from KLSE and try to get it out from the country. Okay, because in 1997, our financial system is more in financial in characteristic. It's merely more towards financial. Okay? So it's not for long-term investment. It's rather for short-term, it is for speculation. Okay? So they take out the money from currency and also all other investment, properties, okay? Because they don't want to get hit also by the currency problem. So our currency was depreciating from 2.5 to 4.5 during the crisis in just a matter of time. Okay, some analysts, economic analysts also predicted our currency will depreciate until ringgit. Okay, so the government has to do something to prevent this from happening, right? So what we do is that we pack. We pack the system, we pack the currency at 3.8. And then we implement capital control. So we have to reduce the capital inflows and outflows. And also we have to control on the purpose of the capital inflows and outflows. So we don't want short term.